Excuse me.
Hello.
Excuse me.
Mrs. Neptune's daughter is doing it.
Child.
Mrs. Neptune's daughter is doing it over there.
Okay.
She is used to it.
Oh, she is?
Okay.
All right. I just told you, she's doing it. She's used to do it all the time.
Okay, thank you.
Just sit down.
Thank you.
so that our worship will be worthy of him. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my misdeeds fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and any of my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Moses said to the people, "Ask now of the days of old, ever since God created man upon the earth, asked from one end of the sky to the other, did anything so great ever happen before? Was it ever heard of? Did a people ever hear the voice of God speaking from the midst of the fire, as you did, and live? Or did any God venture to go and take a nation for himself from the midst of any other nation, by testings, by signs and wonders, by war, with strong hand and outstretched arm, and by great terrors, all of which the Lord your God did for you in Egypt before your very eyes? This is why you must now know and fix in your heart that the Lord is God in the heavens above and on earth below, and that there is no other. You must keep his statutes and commandments that I enjoin on you today, that you and your children after you may prosper, and that you may have a long life on the land which the Lord, your God, is giving you forever. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, for those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received the spirit of adoption. Though through whom we cry, Abba Father, the Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God. And if children and peers, heirs of God and joint heirs of Christ, if only we suffer with them, so that we may also be glorified with them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Send for the gospel of mystery.
Candidate for confirmation, please stand as I call your name. The Reverend Spencer Baptist. Michaela Crystal Bieneme. Micah Alston Boyce. Michael Urban Denmoon. Jalissa Destel.
Present.
Miracle Even Hope. Nasa Lynn Ashley Mary Swan. Keda Joan Alena Mary Swan. Victoria Megan Mary Swan. Wendy Alicia Nelson. Kamaria Mitchell Philip. Whitney Elmid Pierre. Lufeta Maya Regis. Taylor Seffler. Catherine Chinton.
Present.
Natasha Toussaint.
Present.
Lisbeth Chinton.
Present.
Archbishop, I am pleased to present to you the candidate from our parish, St. Helen, for the sacrament of confirmation.
Father, I think they're prepared and are they ready to receive the sacrament?
These candidates have prepared for confirmation by participating in the sacramental life of the church in the parish, by meditating on the Word of God, by attending religion classes, by participating in the retreat and other activities, and by demonstrating Christian service. They have found strength in God's grace and support in our community's prayer and example. Now they ask to be confirmed, and after consultation with their teachers and parents, I testify that they are ready.
My dear sponsors, the Christian life and the demands that flow from the sacraments are not to be taken lightly. Therefore, we are granting these candidates the request to receive the sacrament of confirmation. It is important that the church also hear the testimony of their sponsors who have journeyed with them. So I ask your sponsors, are these candidates ready to be confirmed today?
They are.
I ask you, my brothers and sisters, in this assembly, should these, our brothers and sisters, be confirmed today?
Yes.
My dear candidates, your pastor, sponsors, families, and fellow parishioners have given testimony on your behalf. Are you now ready to receive the sacrament of confirmation?
I am.
Let's give these people a hand. Thank you. And so he said, you can ask him about the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, or maybe about the 12 fruits of the Holy Spirit, or ask him about one of the Ten Commandments. Now, I thought about doing that, but then sisters said to me, Archbishop, that would not be a very good idea. But then sister said, after all, if you're going to be asking anybody those questions, you should be asking one of their sponsors. And so, I think I'll do something different. What I would like to do is to conduct a short experiment, but one that perhaps could help us understand better the role the Holy Spirit is to play in our lives as Catholic Christians. Quiero hacer una pequeña experiencia para mejor poder ayudarnos a entender mejor el papel del Espíritu Santo en nuestra vida de cristianos. Voy a contar hasta tres. Y cuando llegue a tres, quiero que cada uno aquí aguante la respiración y que no vuelvan a respirar hasta que los diga. Tal vez que también te experiencia nunca te toca o cuando viene el oro de su misión, si ustedes pueden hablar a mí con Catolico. Cosa va bien de toi. De mi padre, tu buen que me sufre. De mi padre, si me jisca me dijo santo. I'm going to count to three, I'm going to get to three. I want everyone to hold their breath and don't breathe until I tell you. Todo mundo comprende? Todo mundo entiende? Everyone understand? So I'm speaking in tongues, see that? So, are you ready? Listos. Prepare. One, two, three. Okay, you better breathe. So just like our bodies need oxygen in order to live. So we too, in our lives as Christians, we need that breath of God, which is the Holy Spirit, to make us more alive in Christ, so that living in Christ, we can walk with Him, strengthened by the gifts of the Holy Spirit, that we can walk with Jesus as His disciples on our life's journey. I think that's a pretty good definition of a Christian. A Christian is simply someone that is walking with Jesus on his or her life's journey. We are to walk with him as his disciples. Now, a disciple is something like a student. Jesus is the master, the teacher. We are the disciples, the students. Now, when you're back in brick and mortar schools, I hope everybody will be back in the classroom soon. But when you're back in the classroom, they'll probably tell you, sit up front. Sit up front. So that you can hear what the teacher is saying. Sit up front so that you can see what the teacher is doing. Jesus tells us that if we stay close to Him on our life's journey, we stay close to Him so that we can see what He's doing and hear what He's teaching us. He tells us that if we stay close to Him, we do what He tells us, we do what we see Him doing, that He will lead us on our life's journey. He will lead us to know true peace. He will lead us to experience lasting joy. He will lead us up into glory, the glory of everlasting life. That is what Jesus promises each one of us. And Jesus keeps His promises. But Jesus is also honest with us because He tells us that the road to glory, not earthly glory, but heavenly glory, the road to glory passes along the way of the cross. El camino hacia la gloria pasa por el sendero de la cruz. Ut camino la rua, hace pa chene la cruz. What does this mean for us? Well, Jesus was the Son of God, the Word of God who became flesh. He became one of us. He became a man like us, everything but sin. He came to live close to us. And He came for one reason. Jesus was about just one thing. And that one thing was to do His Father's will, which was to save us. Now, Jesus let nothing get in the way of His doing His Father's will. He didn't let criticism or ridicule discourage Him. He didn't even let persecution or torture stop Him from doing His Father's will. He did His Father's will to the very end, dying on the cross. So, you could say that Jesus was totally committed to doing His Father's will. Now, if we're going to walk with Jesus on our life's journey, then commitment has to be part of our walk as well. Jesus doesn't call us to be so-so disciples. Jesus doesn't call us to mediocrity, He calls us to holiness. And before you confirm today, each of you will be asked to remove your baptismal promises. And in those promises, you pledge to reject Satan, to turn away from sin, and to live as a child of God. Well, honor that commitment. Keep those promises. commitment, and necessary part of our walk with Jesus. As I said, Jesus was totally committed to doing his Father's will. And he gave himself to death on the cross. And dying on the cross, Jesus gave a gift of himself to the Father for us, so that we might have life and have it abundantly. That is what the sacrifice of the cross is all about. It's about Jesus' gift of himself to the Father for us. Now that sacrifice, the sacrifice of the cross, is represented and being present for us today. Each day, but especially on the Lord's Day, on this altar, and on all the altars and all the churches of the world. And it is represented for us so that we who are walking with Jesus on our life's journey might find in our communion in his body and blood the strength to make gifts of ourselves to the Father and to one another. And that is why going to Mass on Sundays is so important for us Catholics. It's what we Catholics do. In fact, going to Mass is what identifies us as Catholics. And we need to be committed to going to Mass on Sundays in order to find that communion in his body and blood to strengthen us to walk with him on our life's journey. Jesus is teaching us here something very important. And he's telling us that if you want to be happy, if you want to be fulfilled, if you want to become the person that God meant you to be, well, that would be accomplished not through self-seeking or self-assertion, but rather through self-pity. Self-sacrifice. Jesus tells us in the gospel, if you would be my disciple, you must deny yourself, take up your cross daily, and follow me. Now, we've all heard these words of Jesus, but sometimes it's hard for us to get our arms around them, because I say, well, how can I be happy if I deny myself? You know, the world tells us if we want it, go for it, take it, grab it. And Jesus is saying, no, don't give it up. Now, Jesus is right. After all, he is Jesus Christ, huh? But he is right because to deny yourself means to say no to yourself. Unless you can say no to yourself, you'll never be able to say, never be free enough to say yes to something that's bigger than yourselves. If you can't say no to yourself, you'll never be able to say yes to a spouse and really mean it. And if you can't say no to yourself, never be able to say yes to God when God asks you to do something really, really hard. And God does ask us to do hard things from time to time. If you don't think so, ask your parents, because God asked them to raise you. Nothing easy about that, is there? It's never been easy to be a disciple of Jesus Christ. We have 2,000 years of church history that show us that. Some of you have chosen saints' names for your congregation, and perhaps you read up about the saints, and if you did, you learned that it wasn't easy to imagine. Jesus Christ. Some of them were misunderstood. Some of them were persecuted. Some of them were even put to death because of their faith in Jesus Christ. But if you don't know these things, just ask any of us sinners here and we can tell you it's not easy to follow Jesus Christ. Now Jesus knows that. He knows who we are. He knows us better than we know ourselves. And Jesus understands that our lives can be messy. This is why he gives us the Holy Spirit. And those gifts of the Holy Spirit in the sacrament of confirmation to strengthen us and guide us so that we can walk with him on our life's journey without being afraid. Without being afraid of the demands of discipleship. And today, being a disciple of Jesus Christ will be demanding. Because we're going to have to face strong headwinds. We're going to have to swim against the tide. Especially in the culture in which we live today, a culture that is increasingly more and more secularized. And secularized is just a big nasty word that describes what happens when a people or a society or a person thinks they can live their lives as if God did not plan. And so in our secularized society, people with religious faith are looked at with increasing hostility, or at best, with cold indifference. And so we're going to have to have the strength of the Holy Spirit so that we can be disciples of Jesus without being afraid. Criticism, ridicule, perhaps even sometimes persecution. And the Spirit is given to us so that we can walk with Jesus without being ashamed. Without being ashamed of the process we might have to carry. Without being ashamed to be known as Catholics, without being ashamed of what we Catholics believe, about what we Catholics believe about the dignity of a human person, the dignity that should be respected and protected from the first moment of conception till natural death. We should not be afraid or ashamed of what we believe about the family, and about marriage, and the union between one man and one woman, for the sake of the family, for the sake of children. So, I'd ask all of you to pray for these young people now as they are being confirmed. Raising for it was always in hands and the walking novels longer, para que abra sus corazones y sus mentes, para que así puedan recibir al Espíritu Santo y colaborando con los dones que produzcan en sus vidas los frutos del Espíritu Santo. Por la primera vez, hay una confirmación. Por lo cual, tu vídeo es mío, pues el guacamole es mi señor. De cuyo quité, cuando salió por mi daño, mi es mi señor. De tiempo, open their minds and hearts and receive the Spirit and His gifts and allow those gifts to produce within them the fruits of the Holy Spirit. Then they will be a witness that will be coherent. A witness that will be convincing. A witness that will make a difference in their lives, in the lives of all the people. him to stand for me. Come, Holy Spirit, now. Oh, let's present this last moment, this last joy. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your people. You stay whole, young and old. And you shall renew the face of the earth.
Amen.
Thank you. Sons and daughters of God, who are confirmed and sealed by the gift of the Holy Spirit today, that they may always give witness to Christ by their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
We pray for their parents, godparents, sponsors, and catechists who have led these candidates in faith, that by their word and example, they may always encourage them to follow the way of our Savior Jesus Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
We pray for ourselves, especially St. Helen Parish community. We all may recognize and give thanks to the risen Lord in the breaking of the bread and in every circumstance where Christ reveals himself to us. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
We remember in our prayers all our school and parish, young people in the Archdiocese of Miami who are or will be receiving the sacrament of confirmation and are graduating from college and high school, that the Holy Spirit give them his gifts to see the Lord in their daily lives as they continue to grow in their intimacy with Christ and the Holy Spirit and the love and respect of Mary. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
For the sick and shut-ins of our community, for those in the hospital, hospice, and nursing homes, for healing and wholeness, for the repose of the souls of the faithful departed in our parish, and we bow our heads and remember in silence our own personal intentions and the intentions of those who have asked for our prayers. We pray to the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
God, again, the Holy Spirit, your apostles, and will that through them their successors, the same Spirit be handed on to the rest of the people. Listen favorably to our prayer and grant that your divine grace, which was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, and now spread to the hearts of those who believe in you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ,
of his passion and death on the cross and the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. We offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church in which we show forth the passing sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, the perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with thee, your worthy servant, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and the entire people who have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly, after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised up to a new hope. Remember these, our brothers and sisters, whom you were pleased to confirm today. Keep them always in your grace. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when your earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, to the apostles and martyrs of St. Helen, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
the supper of the Lamb. Our chance, the Monsignor Jesus, the day, the Mangi Mangi Sah. May Jesus, the Bon Bon Dieu, the way day, the shade, the Sutea. Lord,
desire and love to worship you. Lord be with you.